Welcome to the class of editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding mainstreaming a nuclear Pakistan written by Happimon Jacob. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2, plus this is very important for political science optional students. Now what is this editorial about? This editorial is about what should be the India's reaction in case a civil nuclear deal is offered to Pakistan. This editorial is also about how the deal that is in the prospective could offer India lot of opportunity to build up a pressure on Pakistan and to tame it. Now in order to understand this editorial, first of all, we need to understand the nuclear policy of Pakistan. Now, as far as the nuclear policy of Pakistan is concerned, it is something more than a policy of deterrence. Now, there are two kinds of deterrences in the nuclear domain. One is a strategic deterrence and the other is the tactical deterrence. Now till 1990s, what the Pakistan was following was just the minimum deterrence policy, and this minimum deterrence policy of Pakistan was in response to India's nuclear policy. But after 1990s, they have brought about a change in their nuclear policy. And now what is this change? The change is the full spectrum deterrence. Now, how the minimum deterrence of the Pakistan is different from this full spectrum deterrence? Now, if you look at this concept of minimum deterrence, it says that whatever weapon they are owning, the nuclear weapon, it is just in response to what India is owning. And when it comes to the complete full spectrum deterrence, it means they can use the nuclear warheads, they can use the nuclear missiles, they can use the nuclear weaponry even if the India would be using the conventional weaponry. So the change, the stance in the nuclear policy of Pakistan, it is moved from the strategic domain to the tactical domain. Now we also need to understand what is the difference between strategical and tactical. Now, as far as strategical is concerned, it is about a complete thing, complete framework, holistic framework. Now, the nuclear policy of Pakistan, till few years back, it was just a kind of a strategic nuclear policy. But they have shifted from strategic to tactical nuclear policy. Now, what is this tactical nuclear policy? Now, the tactical nuclear policy of Pakistan says that even if India will be using a conventional warfare, even if India will be using a conventional weaponry, in that case also the Pakistan would be using this nuclear weaponry. Now after 1990s, Pakistan has undergone a change. Non-state actors, they have been playing a phenomenal role in Pakistan. The secessionist movements are high in Pakistan, fundamentalist movements are high in Pakistan, religiosity movements are high in Pakistan, and the role of the army, it had moved in the faces of waxing and waning. And when it wanes, there are problems and there are kind of fears that the nuclear know-how could move in the domain of terrorism. And that could cause a big problem to India. Now, as far as this editorial is concerned, as per Happimon Jacob, the kind of the opportunity that the India is having with respect to the deal that could be signed between Pakistan and United States of America, India could put up a pressure through the international fora on the world stage for the Pakistan to toe the line of the standards. And plus, India can also put up a pressure on Pakistan to tame its nuclear full spectrum deterrence policy. Now, India can also exert a pressure on Pakistan to tame the terrorist outfits. Now, India can also put a pressure on Pakistan to divide its civilian and military nuclear things. India can also put up a pressure on Pakistan to solve the dispute of Kashmir, because if the nuclear weaponry of Pakistan would be legitimized by the international fora, it could cause a problem to the domestic issues that are existent in between India and Pakistan, and more importantly the issue of Kashmir. Now, the India will also get an opportunity to know about the nitty-gritties of the nuclear program of Pakistan. Now, till date, it is not following a very transparent kind of nuclear setup. We are not very clear about the number of nuclear warheads that the Pakistan is having. We are not clear about how it is strategically advanced or less advanced in comparison to India. Now, India would also be exerting a lot of pressure on Pakistan through China, because if China wants the Pakistan to enter the domain of nuclear realm legitimately, in that case, India would also be putting up a pressure on China to on Pakistan to making it come in the domain of nuclear domain as a clean and a free hand. Now, as far as the nuclear policy, as far as the nuclear technology is concerned, it is losing its charm. And in that case, even if the Pakistan would be entering into an agreement with the United States of America, it would be quite difficult for Pakistan to make it effective on the ground. Now, the reasons for it are technological issues, technological prowess that the Pakistan is lacking. Secondly, the amount it had to pay for the nuclear policy, for the nuclear gadgetry, for the nuclear plants to be set up to yield the electricity out of those plants. So it is not going to be an easy task for the Pakistan to set up nuclear technology and to be a legitimate player in the domain of nuclear technology. So this was all for this editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIS Mentors. You can contact me at 845-94-0000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. And to avail the information of the class that we are offering, please visit our websites eiasmentors.com and brainiki.com. And you can also write answers on brainiki.com. We have refurbished the entire website, so it will become quite easy for you to look out for where the questions of the day are placed, and you can just click on that question and you can write your answer. We will evaluate your question and we will provide you with the feedback. You can also install our application. Name of the application is Brainiki. You can find that application from Google Play Store and from App Store. And in case you liked the video, do click on the like button, do share and comment on this video. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.